colorblind. Colorblind? Colorblind po ako. I do not see some shades of colors. I discovered that I was colorblind when I was already in the seminary. Yung mga kaklase ko napapansin, Deo, bakit yung medyas mo, yung isa blue, yung isa green? Hindi ba pareho yan? Hindi. Blue yung isa, green yung isa. Ah, talaga? And then one time I was wearing a polo from abroad. Huh? I'm so happy wearing that polo. And then sabi nung isang kaklase ko, Deo, do you know the color of what you are wearing? Navy blue. Sabi ko, no? Very man, not sure. Baby blue, navy blue. Sabi, hindi. Violet. Violet, no? And, talaga violet to. And minsan po, nasa National Bookstore ako. Nasa bookstore na bumibili po ako ng stationery. I think I was in third year college. Ang tagal kong bumipili ng stationery. Gusto ko yung manly, ha? Pinili ko yung light blue. Okay, light blue na stationery. Bumili po ako marami kasi pag pumasok ko sa seminary, matagal kang di lalabas. Eh. Pagka-uwi namin sa seminaryo, nakita nung mga kaklase ko yung stationery ko. Deo, but color pink ang stationery mo? Ha? Color pink ito? Ang tagal kong pinipili yung light blue. So then, I was quite convinced na talagang colorblind ako. And one time I was giving a activity for children at Saints ko. Bata, I was a seminarian, college seminarian. Kaya lang yung activity ko siguro mga grade 3, grade 2. May coloring. Eh marami yung mga estudyante. Eh konti lang yung supply ko ng Crayola. Pinagpuputol ko yung mga Crayola para to give the students their, kunyari, isang ano, paggawin ko tatlo, para makagamit silang lahat. So, nagre-relax ako kasi may activity sila, drawing, activity, drawing. And then, lumapit sa akin yung ano, yung isang estudyanteng bata. Brother, yes, what do you need? May I get an extra color blue. Tinignan ko yung Crayola pinultol-putol. Wala nang label. Kaya po ako pumapasa sa coloring noon kasi may label. Yellow, brown, green, red, black. Hindi ko makita kung anong color yung blue ginawak niya. Para hindi ako mahalata, sabi ko, ikaw na lang yung pumili. Kasi hindi ko alam kung ano yung blue. Pare-pareho na lang, nakikita ko. In fact, meron na daw ngayon na eyeglass. If you buy it, medyo mahal yata, you can check your color blindness. I think I don't want to really change my color blindness. Okay na po ako, matanda na ako for this. Sanay na po ako. Kumisan, nakikita ko, hindi ba blonde yung kulay ng buhok mo? Hindi ba blue yung mata mo? Parang ganun. Pero hindi naman. Parang hindi ko talaga nakikita the details. Lalo na pag sinabi mong blue versus violet. Usually may color code ako. Green and brown, parang pareho lang. Red and brown, parang pareho lang. Yun po yung color blindness ko. Those shades. Kaya hindi ko alam yung mga burgundy, yung mga ganyan kulay. O kaya lilac, yung mga combinations. Prussia. Parang may, kaya yung mga medyas ko po, black na lang, black. Para sure. Pantalon ko blue, kaya khaki, it's quite safe. And light blue, ganun lang. Pinipili ko na po in advance. I'm not very adventurous when it comes to color. In fact, I feel good. I am with good company. Si Bill Clinton, colorblind. Si Keanu Reeves, colorblind. Si Elvis Presley, colorblind. There are many people who are colorblind, but it doesn't stop them from doing what they have to do in life. In fact, the gospel today is about the scribes and the Pharisees trying to question Jesus, the authority in which he was coming from. And Jesus asked them a simple question.
I will tell you where my authority is coming from. If you tell me, where does John get his authority of his preaching? Is it from heaven or is it from human source? Tapos nang meeting yung mga Pharisees and scribes, pag sinabi nating from heaven ang kanyang authority, then sasabihin sa atin, why did you not believe him? Pero sinabi naman natin, it's from human being, magagalit naman yung followers of John. Marami yun. So sabi nila, they could not commit. You know what? Alam mo yung anong problema nila? They cannot speak because they want to be politically correct. Ngayon po, ganyan din ang panahon natin. Pag nagsasalita ka, you should be careful with your terms. You might insult people. Sa Amerika po, maraming rally, maraming kaguluhan. Just this year, nung namatay yung isang black American. And then may movement doon, Black Lives Matter. Nagkaroon po maraming rally, nagkaroon ng maraming demonstration, maraming sinunog ng police cars, maraming looting, maraming problema other than because of racism or maybe discrimination because of the color of your skin. Ang tawag ko minsan, othering. Othering. You are another. We are different from you. Iba ka sa amin. Ganito kami. Othering is excluding other people. Putting colors, judging them from the color of their skin. There should be a politically correct term from everything. Kuminsan nga, yung kaibigan ko, yung tatay, hindi siya sanay sa mga politically correct. Yung mga matatanda, they say what they want to say. Eh yung kanyang anak, educated po, Lasal. Yung isa naman, Ateneo. Pag nagsasalita ang tatay nila, educated naman tatay niya, kinokorek, Papa. That is not politically correct. And I think the young people are also trying to be sensitive to people with their race, with women's rights, with the minorities, like our Ayetas and Kulot. We don't call them our old terms that we use them. And even our LGBTQ. They have a rainbow flag. And yet, for me, as a blind, colorblind person, other than the color of my eyes that I do not see, it's also to see person as they are, beyond the color. To see the person as you are, beyond your color. Even politically, di ba? Politically, meron tayong tawag sa ganitong political group, meron tayong tawag sa ganitong political group. And the tendency is, we do not listen to each other anymore. O power bias. Kumisa nga, terpa nga natin, nakukulayan ang kanilang pagtingin. Para bang, when you have colors and shades with your perspective, it seems to be biased. My dear friends, I'd rather be colorblind. Because I want to see the person not from their color, but from their person. Not because I am afraid to say anything about anybody, not because I am afraid that they might be correcting me for my politically incorrect terms. No. Because I want to be colorblind in facing other people, because I want to respect them as they are. I want to value their person. I want to honor them for who they are. I think it's not about correctness only. You can always speak politically correct terms, but deep inside you, wala ka naman talaga respeto. You can use politically correct jargons, and yet deep inside you, you don't have that sense of respect. This is our prayer, that as we look at each other, especially in times of difficulties, crisis, politically, economically, even in times of race where magkakasama ang mga tao lalo sa abroad when we don't have the same colors of skin and race, I hope we also become colorblind. We just see people as they are. To go beyond the colors, to see the person, the beautiful person in each one of us. we will not be conscious of being politically correct anymore. Mayroong isang song yung Carpenters. Si Karen Carpenter. She's already dead, but during her times, ang ganda ng song niya. Parang sinasabi niya, kung mahalin mo ko, huwag mo kong mahalin kung ano yung gusto mong mahalin sa akin. Huwag mo kong mahalin dahil mayroon ka lang expectation. Mahalin mo ko kung sino ako, kung ano ako. Do not create an expectation that is not me. Because your bias is already there. Pwede kasi, mahal kita kasi nakikita ko yung nanay ko sa'yo. Mahal kita kasi nakikita ko yung idol ko sa yung ideal person. But when reality sets in, nagiging masakit because you do not love the person as they are, as she is, or as he is. Sabi po nung song, you've got to love me for what I am, for simply being me. Don't love me for what you intend and hope that I might be. If you're only using me to feed your fantasy, you're really not in love, so let me go. I must be free. I think real love and relationship is about respect, valuing a person, and honoring each other. Not because of whatever we have or color from heaven or from humanity. John must be seen as he is, the voice from the wilderness. And in that way we see he's a light that gives us guidance in darkness. May God bless us all. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.